Hello everybody, welcome to my channel Suboxy Creative Minds. And about today's video, I'm very excited about it as it is one of my favorite work. I've made this geode style arcade coaster set as well as tray. This is completely very different concept and very interesting. So to know about the tricks and tips in the process, do watch completely. Enjoy the video. So let us start. As you can see, I have already kept the coaster molds, agate coaster molds in the tray mold. This is a unique and different concept. To know how I make coasters out of tray mold, also finish my unique tray, agate tray, you need to watch this whole video completely. So these are the glass glitter chunks. I bought it from Brownwood for Art. All the materials I'm using here is from Brownwood for Art. I'll be connecting the link in the description below. Can you see how beautiful these chunks are? Here I'm pouring these glass chunks on the side of the tray mold to add little bit geode style in the tray. These chunks I'll be fixing it with the help of the modeling paste from Itsy Bitsy. I'm using resin from Rekhan's Design. It's 1:2 ratio, and for making of this tray I have used 1.3 liters of resin. Here I'm using beautiful pigments from Besto Charms. These are unicorn as well as mermaid pigments. Mix the pigments nicely to avoid lumps. Can you see how beautiful these pigments are? The color is so vibrant. These are definitely one of my favorite pigments. I'm using a white color pearl pigment from Rafat Sheikh. I will be attaching her Insta link in the description below. Adding little bit white color paste pigment from Fortune Chemi. Adding black color pigment from Fortune Chemi as well. So after adding all the pigments like white and black base paint pigments, pearl pigment from Rafat, mermaid and unicorn pigment from Besto Charms, we are ready to pour now. So first I'm adding the mixture of white color paste, pigment paste from Fortune Chemi with Rasan. As you can see, I have started working first in the coasters and then I'll be working for the tray simultaneously. So after adding white color resin from Fortune Chemie, pigmented resin from Fortune Chemie, I'm adding unicorn pearl pigments from Besto Charms. After unicorn pigment, I'm adding black color from Fortune Chemie. So let us start adding resin to the tray as well. I'm adding white color from Fortune Chemie as the first pour for the tray. I will be adding all the colors one by one with the same color combination as we did in the coasters from the corner of the tray. Next, adding a unicorn and mermaid pigment from Besto Charms. Adding some clear resin. To pop up the bubbles, I usually spray isopropyl alcohol, which I bought it from Tina Art and Craft Supplies. This is very easy way to work on your molds. It will not only protect your molds from getting harm from the torch as well as heat gun, but also gives a texture for your outcome and will be helpful to use your molds for a long term. One more tip, important thing which I would like to say is if you are adding isopropyl, don't use the blowtorch as soon as you use the isopropyl or heat gun, so that sometimes it may have a tendency to catch the fire. Please avoid it to do that. I usually don't use blowtorch or heat gun. I definitely prefer every time the isopropyl. I have added more of glass chunks from brown wood for art on the sides to give the more effect, geode effect. So here I'm adding all the same color combinations from white to unicorn and then black and then again clear white on the sides of the tray in the same procedure as I did before previously. So after finishing 6 hours, I'm ready to demold the coasters and excited to see the results. Wow, can you see the effect and the glaze it is showing? especially from the unicorn pigment. I can't tell you how satisfied this demolding is, because it's the first effort I have done and it's a new technique, and hope you are also watching something new. Do let me know in the comments below how you felt about this idea. This idea, it's completely different, which was striking me from past 1 year, but I didn't try it, but now definitely I thought it should be tried. So hope you also enjoyed this making as much as I am doing it. And since our coasters are ready, we'll be proceeding to fill the cavity in the tray with the color combination as we used before. If you want, you can use the other colors also with in the cavity with contrast effect. It's totally upon you. Here I'm adding texture paste from Itsy Bitsy to add more glitter chunks from Brownwood for Art on the side of the tray. Now proceeding towards the filling the cavity, I will be pouring the clear resin first and then proceeding towards the same color combination as we did before in the exact same manner what we did the procedure. Giving an outline to the coaster shapes with my favorite liner from Chrome. Now moving up to attach the handles, this beautiful golden handles, I got it from Color Story by Saloni. I'll be attaching the link below. And since I didn't needed the golden handles, I wanted this to convert into silver. So this procedure is to convert the golden handles into silver. I'm applying glue from Leafing Creations. This glue is specifically used to stick the leaves. After applying the glue, I'll fix the silver leaves, which is again from Leafing Creations. And lastly, I'll be applying a chemical, which is from Leafing Creation as well, to fix the silver leaves perfectly, and later on it won't come out. To secure our works. So it's a very beautiful materials what we get it from Leafing Creation. I'll be attaching their link in the description. and now finally adding a flat coat of resin, clear coat of resin, and then proceeding towards the lining work from the chrome silver pen on the edges. Hope you all love the making and love the tray. Do comment about it, as your feedback means a lot to me. And if you like the video, please click on the like button, as well as if you have not subscribed me yet, do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.